Welcome back to AWS reInvent 2021. This is the live edition. The last year, of course, it was virtual. This is probably the most important hybrid event of the year. Over 20,000 people. We have two sets here at theCUBE. My name is Dave Vellante. Really excited to have Caroline Seymour on. She's the Vice President of Product Marketing at Zerto, which is now an HPE company, and Danielle Greshock, who's the Director of Worldwide Partner SAs at AWS. Folks, welcome to theCUBE. Great to see you.
Yep. Great to be here.
So Caroline, you got some news. Why don't we start there? Hard news, we always like to start with that.
Well, tell first of all, I think I'd just like to talk a little bit about the acquisition because Zerto has been acquired by HPE, and in September we announced disaster recovery as a service as part of the HPE GreenLake platform. And so that's really exciting, both from our Zerto customers as well as also HPE customers. But the innovation continues here at AWS reInvent. We are announcing a new solution, Zerto in Cloud, which is disaster recovery for Amazon EC2. And if I think about the value that it brings to the customers, it's delivering orchestrated disaster recovery. It's delivering that simplicity at scale. And scale is a very important aspect because it'll deliver that from tens to thousands of workloads, and as well, it's helping organizations to drive more operational efficiencies around their processes. So that's it in a sort of a nutshell of the net new news, the Zerto in Cloud for AWS.
Great, thank you for that. So Danielle, I want to ask you, obviously in lockdown, people look to the cloud, and you know, data protection used to be just backup, and then people realize, oh wow, recovery's important. But it used to be a bolt-on, an afterthought. You'd sort of launch the application or the service and you'd say, oh, we got to protect this thing, and whatever, and you'd throw it on there. That's unacceptable today. You're not going to run your digital business with a bolt-on. So what are customers telling you in terms of what they want to see from their data protection portfolios, and how are you seeing the ecosystem and AWS helping them integrate that?
Absolutely. To your point, the pandemic has absolutely accelerated a lot of businesses' movement into the cloud. So companies that hadn't formerly thought about using cloud technologies are now doing that. And for them, in order to have a very simple and easy and scalable data protection solution is critical for them to feel comfortable into moving into AWS. And so that's what we're seeing from a lot of customers. And of course, back to your point about recovery, with the challenges around ransomware, that is definitely an area where a lot of companies have not just done their backup, but they're also testing it and making sure that it's something that they know that they can rely on as they move their workloads into the cloud.
And speaking of ransomware, I mean, it's just front and center. Anybody can be a ransomware today. They go in the dark web, they buy ransomware as a service, they put a stick into a server, and then bad things happen. Hopefully that individual ends up in handcuffs, but not always. And so when we've seen ransoms getting paid, up $40 million ransoms, multi-million dollar ransoms, we all know about these hacks that are front and center. So what are you seeing in terms of the customer base? How are HPE and Zerto helping, and where does AWS fit? Maybe you could start off, Caroline.
It's a great question, because I think from a Zerto and HPE perspective, we look at it from the need for recovery strategy as part of your overarching security. And prevention is one aspect, that you always need a prevention. But to us, it's a matter of not if you're going to be attacked, it's when. And when that gets through your firewalls. And so you need to be able to have a recovery strategy in place that allows you to recover in minutes to within seconds of when an attack actually happens. And I can give a case example for, there's a company, Tencata Protective Fabrics, they're a textile manufacturing company, multi-million business, and they suffered two attacks, a crypto locker attack first time, and they were using more of the traditional backup to tape, and it took them 2 weeks to recover having been attacked, and they suffered significant data loss. And then they deployed Zerto, and with Zerto, unfortunately, a little while later, they were attacked a second time with a more sophisticated case of CryptoLocker. So it continues. But this time, the recovery was very different. What happened was that they were able to recover within minutes, and they had seconds of data loss. And that is because of our CDP technology, CDP being continuous data protection, and that is with our replication and a unique journaling capability that allows you to set up the different checkpoints so you have thousands of recovery points and you can recover to a specific recovery point within seconds of that attack. Very, very powerful.
I want to ask you both a question. And what Caroline was just talking about was the classic metrics in this business, are RPO and RTO. RPO is recovery point objective. I always say, how much data do you want to lose? And people say, none. And you say, okay, how much, what kind of budget do you have? So that's always been the trade-off, although, as you mentioned, it's getting a little bit more cost-effective. And then recovery time objective. How long does it take you to get back up?
Absolutely.
Okay, so those are some of the concepts that you were talking about. I want to ask you, Danielle, it feels like, and Caroline, I'd love for you to chime in, feels like data protection is now becoming, it's certainly a tight adjacency to overall security.
Absolutely.
It's not security per se, SecOps and so forth, but it's becoming, the lines are blurring. How do you see that? You have the shared responsibility model. Where does this whole topic fit in?
Well, I think lots of companies are really finding a lot of value in their data, right? Whereas, you know, perhaps years ago it was less easy to hang on to it, to actually make it valuable, to do metrics and analytics on it, to do machine learning perhaps on it. And so by having products such as Zerto's product, you know, they're now able to hang on to that data and make sure that they have it in perpetuity so that they can do what they need to do on it. So yes, we're seeing, you know, companies that were traditionally storage companies thinking about security companies thinking about data. So yes, all of those lines are being blurred for sure. And I think that, you know, as far as the shared security model, we think of our partners and ourselves, you know, obviously as extensions, and we're really looking to have that best customer experience that we can.
Hey, Caroline, I think every company's a security company. Obviously, Hewlett-Packard Enterprise cares a lot about security. AWS, I don't know any company who says, I don't really care about security. That's not my swim lane. You'd be out of business if you had that attitude. Now, so from your standpoint, where does it fit inside of, you know, your thinking? How are you guys thinking about security, data protection, backup and recovery? Is it all just coming together, or are they still kind of separate entities?
No, you're absolutely right. It is coming together. And what we're seeing is we're having a lot more conversations with CISOs, so the security officers of organizations. And I think what's happening is that's where the budget is too. And so you're seeing the sort of the working together of the IT and also the Office of Security too. So we're having more conversations there. And we see that, as I mentioned before, the recovery strategy is a key element of our focus and what we can do as part of the overarching strategy of an organization.
So how should we think about the cloud? Is it another layer of protection? Is it a replacement for tape? Maybe not, but we need as much protection as possible. So how should we think about the cloud in the context of data protection?
Well, the cloud, yeah, absolutely, can provide an alternative to tape or disk. For example, this year we also added support for immutability for Zerto, for AWS.
Okay.
With Zerto, so we are ensuring in the fact that, you know, data cannot be changed. So that's absolutely critical.
So that's a write once, read only technology. That's a service that you tap. So you're integrating. Zerto is integrating with that capability.
Yeah.
So that's another layer of protection.
That's another layer of protection.
And then, absolutely. And then of course, you know, there's air gaps.
Yep.
Is another part of the strategy. So let's talk strategy for a minute. What's the, I know it's not one size fits all, but what are you seeing as best practice strategies for customers to protect themselves against traditional, just human error, cyber attacks? What's the sort of prevailing approach? How should we think about that?
Well, I mean, you're absolutely right. Those, the the file deletions, the database corruptions, and so our solution to that is our continuous data protection. It absolutely is the ability to be able to get to that granular level of recovery, which you can't do with backups. I'm not saying that backup isn't part of your overall strategy, but if you're actually trying to recover quickly and within seconds to whether it's an attack, to whether it's a file that's deleted, a database corruption, you need that continuous data protection. And that's something that's unique to us that we've been delivering since the day that Zerto was formed. So yeah,
that's your secret sauce, isn't it?
That is our secret sauce.
Is it a very granular ability to dial down, dial up based on your RPO requirements, based on the application requirements, and then bring in the cloud for things like immutability, maybe air gapping, maybe last resort, maybe tape is still the last resort, I don't know. Maybe they're both.
And also, AWS to be a target for disaster recovery, so all backup.
Yeah, talk about that.
Yeah, so with Zerto, what we've enabled is, first of all, if you want to migrate your workloads to AWS, and we're seeing an awful lot of that, we provide that capability, so the mobility aspect. If you are looking at, instead of an on-premises disaster recovery site, you can use AWS as the DR site. And if you want to back up to AWS and use cost-efficient storage, we support that with cloud tiering and immutability. And as I say, today we're announcing Zerto in cloud for AWS, which is once you've got your workloads in AWS, we can protect them now in AWS itself. So the full spectrum. And then earlier this year, we announced Zerto for Kubernetes for EKS workloads. So we're really trying to ensure that we can protect any AWS workload wherever it is.
So Danielle, I look around here, pretty impressive, given that we're in the second year of a pandemic here, pretty packed floor, but the ecosystem is just exploding. That's got to make you feel good. Companies like Zerto choosing to partner with AWS, leaning in, writing to your cloud native tooling. Maybe give us the update on how you see the partnership.
Well, I mean, just to Caroline's earlier point, you can see how Zerto is continuing to innovate, right? And that's really key. So having a cloud native solution and then also having a solution that works for EKS. We're seeing a lot of companies thinking about containers, thinking about serverless. And so, the best partnerships that we have are the ones in which they're innovating with us continuously. And I've known about Zerto since I started in 2014, so they've been around for a long time and they're continuing to do that. And they're working closely with us to do POCs and to help our customers really get what they need in the data protection space and continuing to innovate, which is key.
Yeah, your joint customers, they want that, they need that. You're deep into data protection.
Yes.
Right? You're scale of cloud, but you're not going to have the capabilities of a Zerto stack, so that 1+1 hopefully is greater than 2. How do you, where can we find out more information about the new solutions? What's the call to action here?
Oh, call to action. Well, a couple of things. We've just launched a Zerto for AWS hands-on lab. And what that does is allowing you, your own time, in your own environment, to be able to try Zerto with AWS as a DR target and backup. So we've just launched that, and that enables you to see how Zerto works with AWS. We also have a Zerto for Kubernetes lab as well, so you can see how Zerto works with EKS. And coming soon, we're going to have a Zerto in cloud lab that you can actually see how to protect your workloads in the cloud, in AWS. So those were really the best ways to be able to, for a call to action is try the lab. It really is.
Awesome. Guys, thanks so much for coming to theCUBE. It's a very important topic, and keep up the good work.
Thank you. Thank you for having
me. You're very welcome.
Here.
So we're seeing the evolution of data protection, rethinking data protection in the 2020s. No longer is it a bolt-on cloud, modernization with Kubernetes, deep stacks, fine granularity for your RPO, but also quick recovery, protection from ransomware. It's a whole new world. And we're here to cover it. My name is Dave Vellante. You're watching theCUBE, the leader in high-tech coverage. We'll be right back.